One aspect that, in my view, would be quite important to put an eye on is the short-termism of the financial markets, and especially quarterly reporting. As a manager, I can say that the actual psychological pressure all the time does not really come, or might for certain people definitely, on considering how much money you earn at the end of the month. But the pressure comes from the fact that every quarter you have to make a report on your capability to grow or not grow compared to the previous quarter in earnings, and what is going to happen in the next 3 months, which really is a tremendous pressure to take a short-term attitude in running a bank, in running a company. It's not just a problem of banks, clearly. You know, this is so. While clearly an aspect of, once again, a greediness or ambition, whatever you want to call it, in the market is probably the engine of the world in a way, at the same time, we should also make some thought on how much is possible, at least to send out a message. No? For instance, provocatively, I'm wondering if we shouldn't drop quarterly reporting. Not that that changes a lot, but gives a kind of signal on the fact that we would like to have seen a responsibility by everybody in taking a longer term approach towards then all stakeholders and not only or mainly shareholders. On the point of globalization and regulatory supervision, I can only agree a lot on what is now been moving in terms of finding out better ways of coordination. As a bank that is present with substantial operations in 22 countries, I can say that really managing strong differences in regulation is extremely complicated. It's costly, that eventually ends up translating to more cost for consumers and corporates, also makes more difficult the risk management process, which is also very, very relevant. Last point I would like to mention, picking up on a comment made before by Daniel, is really that in this moment, I can say that the job that we're having in terms of managing on one side to keep providing liquidity to the economy, on the other side to managing in the best possible way the level of risk is extremely difficult. It's never been as difficult as in this moment, in a sense that the expectations in terms of being able to provide liquidity nowadays are huge. No? At the same time, clearly, the money we are providing is depositors' money. That's something that often gets forgotten by public opinion and by other observers. Clearly, in a context where we are missing completely the number one information we would love to have, which is the length of the crisis, that would help us to understand if what we have in front currently is also on the side of customers, purely a liquidity problem, or clearly boiling towards a solvency problem. In this context, the type of things we are trying to do, starting with a pilot project in Italy that we plan to expand also in other countries where we are present, is effectively to try and open up as much as possible our books in terms of transparency on the criteria we are using for credit, on the number of companies we are financing, on the number of companies we are turning down. So, for instance, we are providing these days lots of information to the general public about for instance, the fact that over the last 2 months we have been giving credit to three companies out of four that have been asking us, which is an interesting point because three out of four, I'm sure everybody of us can have different opinion if it is too much or is it too little. No? And generally speaking, we can see a lot of people saying that is a problem, that what is happening to this other fourth company, regulators may tell us instead that we are too expansive, no? So it was just to give an example, no? In reality, of how difficult in this moment is the job, and I believe that, however, there is a need on our side to provide even or to provide more and more transparency, because clearly, in this pendulum swing of a public service role of banks versus private role of banks. By remaining private, as I believe is very, very important, still we have to be extremely transparent, extremely open towards all stakeholders.
Thank you. I move to Mr. Scriva now.
Yes. Yes, I'd like to focus on a number of concrete issues that are elements that could be undertaken in order to to limit the problems that we are suffering. And I think that, well, I tend to agree that overregulation should be avoided. I think there are a number of things that can be better regulated. Talking about this issue of greedy bankers, I think that what matters here most is incentives. So incentives need to be adjusted. And a key issue to me is the compensation schemes. The compensation schemes are not well designed on some occasions and leads to short-termism, to try to very rapidly obtain profit without taking a medium to long-term view in business. So I think that there is a need for setting a framework for compensation scheme in the banking system in order to create incentive for longer-term actions and to avoid the procyclicality that we have witnessed in this occasion and in many occasions during the booms. A second field where I think regulation can be undertaken is on avoiding a business model which rely very much on upfront fees without a significant component of risk-taking. I mean, when basically in the origin of credit, a number of actors in the first stage of the process are not involved in the risk-taking, but simply get the fees up front and that's it. This has led certainly to very low quality origination of credit. So this is a field where I think there is a need for very tough regulation, and we can learn a lot about what has happened over the last few years. And a third field, I think, that concrete steps should be taken in terms of regulation is on the leveraging, and leveraging in general terms, not only of banks, but also of firms and families. And here I'm thinking of the Irish or Spanish case, where one problem I see now, with the benefit of hindsight, is that in a situation of huge liquidity, many agents in the economy and banks who were involved on the other side were given the possibility of acquiring assets basically without putting equity, without putting savings, without down payments. I mean, I think we need to go for a balance here, and although there is a problem of affordability and there are trade-offs to be dealt with, I think there is a need for, in any origination of credit, that the debtor is putting savings, is assigning savings. I mean, there is equity there. The same applies of all these leverage buyout operations, whether about the auctions here, where the higher the leverage ratio, the better. And that has been a disaster. So there is a need for ensuring that all agents that are engaging in investment in the economy, either household firms or whatever, or banks, are given a number of guidelines in terms of the savings that, or the money they are going to put. They cannot fully rely on that. And that has been, I think, a key problem, and there were no guidelines, no rules in this direction. And a final word on the Lavoisier group that I didn't mention. I think that this is certainly an initiative from the Commission, and it needs to be welcomed, no doubt, because it has been done very, very rapidly. And my personal view is that the report is quite good. I mean, you can discuss dispute here and there some elements, but is ambitious enough, I would say, and if implemented, it will change the regulatory landscape in Europe. And I like